As schools across the country reopen for the second term, security bodies in the country have called out for strict adherence to the set of security measures to ensure learners and teachers' safety while in school. During today's joint security briefing held at the police headquarters in Naguru, police spokesperson Fred Enanga advised school proprietors to be extra vigilant as learners return. Matrons have been asked to look out for abused children and help them access justice and rehabilitation.
Basically, remind all schools to review their security, emergency preparations, supervision and other school safety fundamentals, the visitor procedures and access controls in all schools need to be strictly followed. And we always call upon the matrons, especially of the girl child, to use this opportunity to also examine children returning to school for any signs of child abuse during their holiday.
Installing security devices such as CCTV cameras, smoke detectors, fire extinguishers is also important in ensuring that the learners are safe while at school.
All school leaders, administrators in all districts to keep in mind that a secure environment is very critical during this school period, and we call upon all school administrators to liaise with our territorial commanders in case of any threats regarding their schools.
Also, police called school heads to come out and report their staff who are engaged in illicit relationships with their learners.
We had an incident in one of the international schools where we arrested a teacher and charged him to court for aggravated defilement. This operation was carried out by the Directorate of CID, where a teacher of Ambrozoli International School, Bugorobi, was arrested for the aggravated defilement of a 3.5-year-old female pupil. The facts gathered so far indicate that Beli Chirimwimana, who is a teacher of Burundian origin, during the months of February and March, would escort one of the girl childs in his classroom to the toilets. And while at the toilets, he would get to use his fingers to inappropriately assault sexually this 3.5-year-old girl victim.
From the Traffic and Road Safety Directorate, at least 103 died in road accidents in the past 1 week. Farida Nampima, the traffic police spokesperson, revealed that 346 road accidents were registered between 1st and 7th March, 64 were fatal, 168 were serious, and 114 were minor.
103 people died, and 295 sustained injuries. The major cause of the death during these accidents were attributed to bleeding. After the accidents, people die because there is bleeding. They delay to attend to them, so we can save lives if attention is given immediately those accidents happen. And the other issue that caused these accidents is reckless driving. People should respect signages. People should stop driving recklessly on the roads. Avoid phone driving, avoid overtaking in corners, respect signage. We can fight carnage together. All schools are expected to open today for term 2 on the 9th May 2022.